Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we'll see how to apply simple data validation in Excel. So guys, data validation is very useful feature of Excel, by using which we can ensure that our users are entering correct data in our spreadsheet. So I'll cover all the options available in data validation today, so which are list, date, whole numbers, decimal numbers, times, and some other. There are also system errors which we can set up by applying data validation. Guys, we'll see all this in our today's video. So guys, before continuing, I would like to request you all to please like, share and subscribe our videos to get the more, and also please don't forget to press the bell icon to get the more updates on our latest videos. Thank you guys.
So let us go to the next slide and see what do we have for data validation today. So let us first understand what is data validation. Excel data validation is a feature that restricts validates user input into a worksheet. Technically, you can create a validation rule that controls what kind of data can be entered into a certain cell. So if you want me to give an example, so I'll take you to the image. So here we have Facebook sign up page. So almost all of you have visited Facebook and you might have done the registrations, you might have gone through the registration page. So here we have sample registration page. So if you see, we have all these fields: first name, last name, your email, password, and then we have the validations here. So so the very first validation here is 6. So it might have option of gender, male and female, and then we have birthday, our birthday, which is month, day and year. So when you go to the birthday, in the month field, you will only find January, February till December. So you will not find anything which you can manually enter or the invalid month. So it will only have all the valid months, and then days. So in days field, you will find dates from 1 to 31st. You will never find 32nd or the day greater than 31. For some months there will be only 28 or 29 days, but when you select the month accordingly, you will see the particular last days for that month. And then we have year. So here we'll have the list of years close to the current year. So this is what the data validation is. I have created an example for today where we'll look into data validation in very detail. Super Fitness gym client details. This is an Excel format where we will input all the details of our clients. So if you see, and our branches are Mumbai, Pune, and let me take you to the each field and column of the spreadsheet. So we have ID, client name, gender, age, location, registration date, weekday, registration time and mobile number. So let us see what data validations we have used for this spreadsheet. So let me first go to the ID. So I'll input 1, 2 here and 3. I can input numbers here. So let me try by inputting number 0. See, it is not accepting number 0 because IDs can be only numbers starts from 1. It can go higher, but no negative numbers or zeros. So I'll retry. I'll try inputting some character here, A. It is not accepting. So it means that we have applied a data validation here which will only accept the numbers greater than 0. So let us go to the next field, which is client name. Here we don't have any validation. I can put my name here, and let us go to the next tab, which is gender. So we have a drop down here and we have applied list here, so we can select male or female from this list. So if you see, we cannot manually input any other text here because we have applied data validation. It will not allow any other text to input. That's what the feature of data validation is. And then we have one more field, which is age. If you see in the brackets, we have age 18 to 15, which means our gym authorities have restricted people below 18 and greater than 15. I'm sure that there will be no such restriction in real world, but for just an example, we have used this as a restriction. So I'll put 25 here, it is accepting. Let me try putting 17. See, we have an error message which is saying invalid age, we cannot allow the people below 18 and above age. Real-time scenarios, you can use these examples and apply the validations as per your needs. This is very useful. Again, let me try input the number greater than 50. So I'll put 52, do not accept. I'll put 50, it is accepting. That's what the beauty of data validation is. And then we have location here, we have used list. If you click on the drop down, it will show us the location. So as our branches are only in Mumbai, Pune and Nasik, so if by mistake if anyone updates any other location, it will not accept. Even if you try putting wrong cell spelling for Mumbai, it will not accept. So it will enforce you to select the proper city. And then we have registration date. So here I have applied option of date and data validation. So I'll try putting today's date here, which is 15th April 2020. Yeah, it is accepting. So let us try putting tomorrow's date, which is 16/4/2020. See, it is not accepting. So what error do we have here is invalid date. Date cannot be greater than today. So we can only take the registrations for today, not for the future date. So that's what the data validation here. And then we have weekday. So let us see what do we have in the drop down. So we have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So it means we have off on Sunday, so hence we don't have Sunday option here. So by default, user cannot select the Sunday, which is not applicable. And then we have registration times here. So I'll put some time here, 10:30. So it is saying 10:30 a.m. So I'll try putting 16 hours, which is 4 p.m. So let me try putting some other time which will not accept. So by in the data validation, I have applied morning 9 a.m. to evening 7. I'll try putting 8:30. Let's see if it accepts. So it is not accepting. So we have an error message here. Registration hours are 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. only. So hence we cannot input the time which is not equal to or in between the 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. And then we have mobile number field here. So let me try putting some mobile number. See, it is not accepting. So what error do we have here is invalid number. Mobile number should have 10 digits. So let me try putting 10 digits. See, it is accepting. Again, let me try with some valid. See, it is not accepting. So this is what the data validation is. So we have covered almost all options in the data validation. So guys, in our next video, we'll see what data validations we have applied for each of this field in detail. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe our videos. We are planning to share more videos on Advanced Excel soon. So don't forget to press bell icon to get the notifications of our latest videos. Thank you guys.